Hello everybody, my name is Dalton Nelson and today I'd like to give my thoughts on a game I just beat, that game being Mega Man 6 for the PS4. Mega Man 6 was developed and published by Capcom. It is a 2D side-scrolling action platformer. Mega Man 6 is a very special game within the franchise. It marks the end of the NES-era games, as all later releases would not be released on the NES console. Also, like Mega Man 5, Mega Man 6 is not looked upon very favorably by its community. However, if there is anything I learned from last year, it's to not really listen to communities. Something some of my friends and family could learn. And so after really liking Mega Man 5, I was really looking forward to playing Mega Man 6, to see what they would do to cap off the NES era. To say that I really liked Mega Man 6 is an understatement. I really loved what Capcom brought to the table within Mega Man 6. It really feels like they improved even more upon the Mega Man 5 formula, bringing a video game experience that left me smiling ear to ear. So let's get into why I liked Mega Man 6 so much. First, Mega Man's companion, Rush, now isn't a weapon that you use anymore. Instead, Rush will turn into suits for Mega Man that give him a jetpack or power suit. No ammo is spent with these suits, meaning you can use these abilities an unlimited amount of times. Cracked blocks appear all over the stages in this game, making them very replayable for extra goodies or alternative routes. When you pick a stage to go into, the introduction sequence now has a lot of detail that went into it, from the visual design to the stats about the boss that appear on the screen. Speaking of bosses, the lightning that strikes as a boss is appearing gives a foreboding atmosphere to the fight ahead. The story of Mega Man 6 is kind of dumb, and the bad guy was actually Dr. Wily behind the scenes twist got old 2 games ago. However, if there is anything to love about Mega Man 6, it's its stage design. The stage design in this game is fantastic and feels inspired. Flame Man stage is my favorite stage. It has a fantastic Arabic-inspired background. There's some great uses of purples and yellows in this stage. The oil mechanic and how it plays with fire is very creative and interesting. The way the game teaches you about this mechanic is also very great. The enemies that need to be tipped over by a charge shot are also dealt with the player in mind. The enemies that charge toward you are also placed geniusly. The music in Flame Man's stage is fantastic. Flame Man's ground attack is a little hard to dodge because of not knowing where the pillars of fires will appear, but the Flame Blast weapon is a nice weapon that you have to use predictively to get the most out of it. Meanwhile, with Windman stage, I love the wind turbine mechanics. The platforms that switch when you land on them create a great tension and require timing to traverse. I also love the panda enemies in this stage that require you to use spatial techniques, but depending on how far or how close you are to this enemy will have a different attack to try to get you with. The use of pulling in the fight against Windman is very appropriate, and I like the Windstorm weapon as well that you get from this fight. It's fairly straightforward, but requires some forethought, as the wind will always go towards the ground. In Blizzard Man stage, the platforms that explode 3 seconds after you touch them are introduced fantastically within this stage. They create some great tension-filled gameplay moments. Every enemy in this stage has their behavior communicated to the player in such a smart fashion. Each has their own individual experience you go through, so you can learn how they behave each time. The submarine set piece in this stage reminds me of the airships from Super Mario Bros. 3, and I think that is a good thing. This part is very fun, with the combination of the spikes at the top of the screen and the way the submarine floats up and down. Blizzard Man is my favorite visual design of a character in this game. His round, white body with the skis and the Santa hat he wears is so endearing. I love this character design overall. The Blizzard attack acts like a slow spread shot, which in turn makes it a great weapon to use on enemies that you can't reach. In Plant Man stage, I love the detailed forest background of this stage. Every enemy in the stage is based off of some kind of animal or bug, which is very appropriate with the background. The gorilla enemy teases the behavior of a boss that comes later on in the game, and is a very clever placement by the developers. The enemies that come out of the pits as soon as you come up to them are back in the form of fish in this stage, but at least they're better introduced in this game. I like the life pellets being placed in the middle of the flower tiles. It's a nice visual detail that adds to the detail of the stage as well as the difficulty. Plant Man himself has a nice, semi-predictable pattern. However, the plant barrier weapon is your standard Mega Man shield power-up. Yamato Man stage is the most straightforward stage out of the bunch, but I do love the Japanese-inspired backdrop of this stage, as well as the Japanese-inspired enemies. Speaking of straightforward, the Yamato Spear offers shooting at a high fire rate. In Nightman stage, the entire stage takes place in this alchemist-like castle. This stage probably inspired visual designs within the game Shovel Knight. This stage has some of the hardest enemies to deal with in the game. The bounce section of the stage is a little frustrating to get through, but I do like the visual design of, well, everything within Nightman's fight. I thought there was a lot of thought put into this screen alone. The Night Crusher weapon that you get from this fight is very fun to use. It reminds me of the Yo-Yo Copy ability from Kirby Superstar, a game that would come 3 years after this game. Centaur Man stage has a lovely background with these pillars that look very beautiful. As a water level, the stage has a lot of visual aquatic-based enemy designs. The stage also has a lot of spikes, but the designs used here use the physics of water-based platforming very well. I love the part of this stage where water floats at the top of the stage, and you have to clear large pits using this water. However, the Centaur Flash weapon you get from the stage is a weapon that I couldn't find much use of outside of the Windman fight. Finally, Tomahawk Man has a great western-themed stage. I love the cowboy robots that look like gunslingers. I also love the metal dispensers. What a great idea these are. And there's this sunset screen that is visually stunning. One of the best NES backgrounds I have ever seen. The silver tomahawk weapon is a great upwards arced weapon, useful for enemies above you. In conclusion, I can say that Mega Man 6 is my favorite Mega Man game out of the bunch. This game blows Mega Man 5 out of the water, and I truly believe that this Mega Man game is one of the most fun platforming experiences that you could ever play. So with that in mind, I'm going to give Mega Man 6 a final score of a 9 out of 10. There were a couple things that I didn't like about the game, but overall I think this was a fantastic game to end off the NES Mega Man
games.
A fantastic game to end off the Mega Man Legacy Collection, and a fantastic game to start out the year. That concludes my review of Mega Man 6. If you like my reviews, you can like, comment, or subscribe. I also have social media links down in the description below, as well as a link to my online portfolio, where you can see game design works that I have done. And with that out of the way, please make sure to have a nice day.